Hello, today we'll be painting a turkey dinner. Start by drawing a large ellipse. This will be the top of your turkey. Now, to connect that, you want to draw a shallow ellipse, and that will be the bottom of your turkey. Make sure not to make it a straight line so that it has some depth and looks like it's sitting on a plate. Now you should take an eraser and draw a circle around it. This will give you the size of your turkey leg, and the base of it. Now draw two straight parallel lines coming off of that circle you just drew to signify how long your turkey leg is. Now to connect those two lines you just drew, draw a heart, and that will be the shape of the bone. After that, draw two curved lines from that heart shape you just drew to your circle, and that will fill out the turkey leg and make it look more like a leg instead of the parallel lines. And you can erase all those inside lines. About half an inch away from the first leg you drew, you want to follow its outline and draw your second leg. Now draw little zigzags across the leg to signify where the meat meets the bone. At the bottom of your turkey, you want to draw a little half oval, and that will be the butt of the turkey. Now take your eraser to measure out the height of your turkey wing. I just marked the top and the bottom of where it will be. Now that I have that measurement, I use triangles to draw out my turkey wing. I make sure to curve my lines so they look more like a wing. Going to draw a line straight through your turkey to make your table. Make sure to draw kind of lightly, that way it's easier to erase later. About an inch away from the top of the canvas and the top of the turkey. This is to get in the height of our window that we will have in the scene. Thank you. Using your eraser, mark out 2 points on either side of the canvas. Now, using all four of those marks we have, measure out a rectangle. From the center of our rectangle we just made, measure out about 1/4 inch and mark on both sides where it will be. Connect your marks with a straight line to make your window panes. Now erase any unwanted inside lines. Now draw two small ovals at the top corners of your window, and that will be a curtain hook. Connect those two ovals with a curved line. Now connect the bottom with a deeper curve, and that will make part of your curtain. Erase the unwanted inside lines, like the top of the window pane. Now draw some smaller curved lines for the folds in the fabric. Draw wavy lines for the curtain coming down on either side. Like you did for the top of the curtain, you want to draw small curvy lines for the folds. I would recommend taking your ruler to find the bottom of the other curtain so that they will be equal. Just make a straight line across. Now draw little wispies of steam coming off the turkey to show heat. Between the turkey and the table, you want to draw an oval for the plate that the turkey is sitting on. When you're drawing this, just draw straight through your turkey. That way you will get an even plate on both sides. And it won't look weird. Once you finish drawing your plate, erase your inside lines. type of garnish. Using basic shapes, you can build all of your garnish around your turkey. Examples would be using circles for lemons, ovals for grapes, and squiggly lines for the lettuce. When drawing rosemary for the garnish, I simply drew straight lines and then made little figure eights continuously for the leaves. We are ready to paint. Starting with our background, we will take a small bit of yellow and red to mix an orange color for the wall. taking equal parts white, brown, and red, mix those together to make a shade for your table. Now grab some brown and a small drop of yellow and mix those together to make a shade for your turkey. Thank you. Now, taking more white to blue, mix together a light blue color. When you apply the blue to your canvas, make sure to wet your paintbrush before you touch your canvas so that the color comes off less opaque and more transparent. That way you get more of the look of a window. Thank you. accidentally paint a little bit more than you meant to, you can just clean off your brush, take some of the water, and wipe away that spot. If you forgot to color in the wall like I did, you can do that now. Don't forget to replace your water when it becomes dirty, or else it will mess up your colors later. Now let's grab some yellow and paint in the curtain. I'm going to take some of that color that we created for our table and actually use that as the shadows for the curtain folds. Thank you. we're going to take equal parts white and brown, just a small drop of yellow, mix those together for our varnish color. When painting the rosemary, use a small flicking motion to get the leaves colored in. Now take a small bit of green onto your brush and flick that on to add some dimension to your rosemary. Now grab some green, the color in lettuce, leaves, and grapes. Grab some yellow to color in your lemons. use white to make highlights on your lemons and grapes. Still using white, paint in the steam that you made earlier. small amount of white, yellow, and blue mixed together to get your plate color. Now taking that brown that we mixed together originally for the garnish, use that on your curtain hook. Now fix any streaky spots in your painting. I had dropped a bit of water onto part of my window and I just went over it with some more blue. need to color in the steam more than once to really make it pop, and your highlight marks too. Now let's add more steam marks to make it look more dramatic and more highlights to the rest of our food, like our turkey. Make it look juicy. Taking a tiny bit of black to more brown, mix those together to make a shadow for your turkey. taking a small amount of black to more green. We're going to mix those together to make a shadow shade for any of our greenery. All done. Don't forget to sign your work of art, and I hope you had a good time. Thank you.